start of what's going to be many battles at the net between Ermacora and Schweiner. Schweiner coming out on top and really setting his stall out very, very early. Huge statement of intent. Big block. Czech Republic lead 2-0. This time, though, it's a good wipe out. Wipe off. Block out for Ermacora. Just a little late in the press from Schweiner. Ermacora will serve, he'll scurry to the net. They have the good end at the moment. Austria, the wind's blowing into their faces. Chase on for the Czech Republic. Line was the call again. It's another good use of the block, but that's three touches in a row for Schweiner. Ermacora not having a clean hit, but he won't matter. He doesn't care. He's got block out here. Just takes Schweiner on his left arm, closest to the antenna. Can't put that back into court. Oh dear, that was snuck away from Pristau's by Ermacora. He won't be too happy with that. A little smile, but that was an opportunity wasted for Austria because Pristau was waiting for this. And the pesky long arms of Ermacora got in the way. You'd rather have two players going for the ball and it not come back than two players not go for the ball at all. That's better. Ermacora this time goes cross court and he has loads of space to work with to level the scores up. First side switch. And nothing really to choose between the two teams. They've been testing each other out, probing and pressing to see what will give and what won't. It's a great pass and a very nice put away. Having Schweiner pushed to his left, but he's able to come back inside and bringing the block in, left him loads of space to go back to the line. Nice setting there. Pristau's now with the serve. Yeah, Perušić, my apologies. Pristau's is setting. Too much of a gap at the net from Schweiner. You can see that from that angle. And that's why the ball went down his own side. Pokey signaled really early, hand was up, which meant there was no hit coming. But Pristau's in defence. He decided to go the wrong way, as it turned out. That's another one down the side of Schweiner. Again, he's just not close the block. As soon as his hands get above the net, he really wants to be getting across the net, not letting any gap. But he's going up and then pressing, and he's left too much space between himself and the top of the net. The reason he can go straight across the net in one motion is because he's so tall. So too Ermacora. You see Alisson do it, you see Dahlhauser do it. 6'7" and above like that, you can block like an indoor blocker. Don't need a second movement. That's well played. Just the ball that scooped the net, not the hands of Pristau's. Ermacora left quite a lot of line considering that's what he must have been taking, because Pristaus has sat. Yes, he was taking the line, but look how much he's left for it to go to the side of him and land in. Didn't quite get his positioning right. It's a big call of line. McCrory decided to go cross court, but not finding the angle he wanted in Czech Republic. They have a 2-point cushion now. James once again. Side out. Two line blocks called. Block. Another big crumper. Lemakora putting that one on the sand with no bother whatsoever. Oh, that's a great chase. Can only come back cross court. Austria waiting and popped up nicely, so there could have been a second ball over. But it goes on a traditional three, and the power of Ermakora too much for Perusic to deal with. Austria had got themselves back level. Czech Republic edge in front again. The scoreboard is ticking along nicely. That's why the Czech Republic is concerned. They are feeling pretty good about things right now, though. Not being stressed that much by Austria. Quite happy to go after Martin Ermakora, even though he is 2 metres and three. They don't fancy Pristaus because of his ability to move the ball around the block. Exactly like that.
Nice good shot. Penal, what a match, guys. The winner gets the bronze medal.
We're going to head into the technical timeout with just 1 point separating them, and it's a block from Ermakora, his first. That was a brave effort. It's difficult enough to walk on the sand, let alone sprint that fast. That was some very quick feet from Perusic, but unfortunately didn't get enough of the ball to bring it back into play. That was on. So fast, that swing. Going at Pristaus. Did well to get his hands on it. A lot of heat in that. Pristaus, unfortunately, was like a goalkeeper then, tipping it over the bar. couldn't quite keep his hands where he wanted them, and he ended up just arching back a little too much. That was tricky. Perušić was almost getting a little bit worried as Unokura knew he had to give the ball over, but he wanted to make it difficult. However, you don't want to make an unforced error like that. And just a delay because the scoreboard on the main screen was out of sync. It was showing 13-11 to the 12-all. And it's 13-12 now, though, for the Czech Republic. Touch ace, courtesy of this serve. That's a brilliant serve. Gustav's not giving up on it. Nikolai Lupo watching on. Nikolai Lupo just watching on. It's a good opportunity as well for players to watch these the other teams, these two, the Czech Republic and Austria, making a name for themselves, becoming more of a force on the main draw. So it's so important that you have an arsenal, you have your little playbook, a dossier, if you like, of all the players you're going to play against on the tour, making those notes so that you've scouted them, you pick up, you know their tendencies, you can go to that playbook and say, right, we've got so-and-so coming up, oh yeah, well, he likes to do this in that situation, and we've seen him do that and do this, and then you can build your game plans. And they do change as players change and players evolve. Your game plan against one team in one tournament might be different in the next. Might be different from match to match, bearing in mind these two played each other in Pool G. That's a great block from Schweiner. That's his second block point. The positioning there for Perušić. The angle from Umakura just too good. It just shows you what the respect that Czech Republic have for Pustau is, that they would rather deal with the height and power of Umakura than the guile and skill of Pustau. Plus, what they're also eliminating with their serving, as they take the end and lead by two, is by serving at Umakura, he is less likely, if at all, to put the ball up on two for Pristaus to have a swing. Whereas the other way round, Pristaus can then put Umakura in because of his skill levels. A bit like playing Lucena and Dalhauser. Everyone goes after Lucena, but they still have to be so, so careful, because if there's an opportunity for Lucena to put it up, Dalhauser of the States to go over on two, they'll take it. This is where Austria will need to make their move if they're going to be able to. As I mentioned at the start of the broadcast, Austria won, lost I should say, against the Czech Republic in the pool. But that's a good point to get back. They're now getting themselves right back into this set, which is what they need to do. Continues on behind Perušić, who uses the ball and the speed of the ball to carry that on into the block and away from Pustau. ball and a good lead. And we're square once again. Full swing up high, able then to hit hard or play the shot. Good touch, another chance here for Austria, but Czech Republic now have an opportunity, but that caught Schweiner, so he had to play it as his block counts as a touch. Oh, that's too tight to the net. And set up for Schweiner and Mikula, doing the Czech Republic a big favour. That's not what was required. Now, quite rightly, Kristajic having a little word and saying, well, he's touched that before I have, and he's touched it on my side of the net. Just questioning the referee as to whether that was the case. So the ball has been set. Whose side is it on? The referee deemed it to be on the side of the Czech Republic and therefore eligible for them to play it. Not soccer. Schweiner's fine. It's a nice roll. In fact, Schweiner had gone under the net. Wasn't there Mikula, but he's okay. Be a carry against him. Whoa, that was fine. What are you talking about? That was a perfectly good reactionary dig. It might have stuck in my hands for a little bit too long. But we're keeping the ball flying. We have no clue where it gone. Whoop. There you go. Czech Republic now move very close to taking this set. 2 points required. Was the call, but it doesn't mean you have to take it. It does get a bit frustrating though if you are making calls and your partner's going the other way and not scoring from it. It's set point now for the Czech Republic. Schweiner with the serve. Drop quickly. It looked like it was in, didn't it? It was a long delay from the lines official, but eventually the flag went up to signal out, and so the first set point is saved. But it's a gift from Austria on set point number two, and the Czech Republic take that opening set 21-18. Yeah. Away we go with set two. Cross court block being signalled. And a line block against Perusic, but it's easily put away by the Czech Republic, and they take the opening point after taking the opening set 21-18. Perusic now will serve, putting themselves instantly into their strong rotation with their main blocker at the net, ready to pounce. A little change up with Irma Korat trying to play some defense. Didn't quite work for Austria. Schweiner to serve. That was a miss hit from Irma Korat. Good dig. Chance here for 4-1. That was an interesting play from Irma Korat because he went high hands. The ball was really not hard driven, but he must have just had his hands together for it not to be the double. Subjective call. And the referee let it play. Czech Republic didn't argue the point anyway because they've won it, so it doesn't really matter. Swing. Really nice work from Martin Irma Korat. Interesting serve, that one. Ron Pristals trying to put it up into the sky and let the wind take care of it. That didn't happen though. That serve routine from Perusic is a carbon copy of Julius Brink when he was playing a few years back representing Germany. Julius Brink, Olympic gold medalist and world champion, gold medalist from London 2012 with Jonas Reckermann. Definitely Perusic has modelled his serve on Julius Brink's. And certainly his pre-serve routine anyway. Julius Brink was one of the first players to do the jump float serve from way back off the court. You just stand all the way back by the advertising hoardings and have a jump float serve instead of having it from just inside the baseline when taking off. Just brought a new perspective and a different trajectory to the ball coming on a longer, flatter plane. And the reason for the jump float serve in the men's game, and in the women's game for that matter as well, is because it's more difficult to deal with a ball that is coming at you on a relative straight line than it is on a parabola, on an arc. Because you can pick the end point once you've seen the start point on its trajectory. Whereas when it's coming at you flat, very, very difficult. Timeout called by Austria. They're in a bit of trouble here. We'll be right back. was a decent ball in. Unfortunately, though, Prestige was not well balanced to have that swing. Schweiner serve. Big lead this for the Czech Republic in the second set. And if the Czech Republic can hold their side out game together, it's going to be really difficult for Austria to get back into this. Take those all day long, 3 points, but they don't have to work for them. And now what they'll look to do is, they don't even really need to serve hard here, just got to get the ball in and make Austria work for their side out, expending more energy and keeping the pressure on. Well, the errors are coming thick and fast here for Austria. They're starting to crumble in the heat of Cancun. Should I say melt? It is meltingly hot. Perisic. Good touch. Well, it was the right idea. Just that contact not high enough. Just something for Austria to latch onto with that point. Try and build something. Solid stuff at the moment. Czech Republic don't look fazed by anything that Austria are trying to do to them. Schweiner's made a lot of touches against Ermacora, but he's only actually made one block. Two blocks, I should say, for points. Ermacora has had one. Certainly where Ermacora needs to step up here, try and help he and his teammate back into it, but they keep missing it. They've got no chance, absolutely no chance at all if they're not going to get the ball in play. Very good leave that from Andrej Perisic. Very impressive hit from Ermacora, but it is only a side out point. Very clever from Perisic. Just looking at the way Schweiner's blocking and setting up against Ermacora, you just wonder, don't you, whether or not it's worth him going up left hand into the right shoulder of Ermacora, but then dropping his right hand well inside to see if he can make a block. He's quite narrow. As high as he gets, he's not necessarily taking a great deal of space away in front of Ermacora. It's not out of Austria's reach just yet, but it is slipping away as we go into the technical timeout. Guys, to be happy. Stouts. Going after Schweiner. Battle of the big guys at the net. Only a continuation block though for Irma Kora. And Perusic able to smuggle that one past the block to increase the Czech Republic's lead here in this second set. They are getting awfully close to a bronze medal. Couldn't have come at a better time. Ace serve, Irma Kora left standing. The Czech Republic will be really fancying their chances here now, if they weren't already. Oh, it's another ace. This one straight down the middle and pinballing off of the Austrian duo, Irma Kora and Pristals, into that corridor of uncertainty. Oh, that's got him right in the face as well, Pristals. That'd have stung. Perusic is now on a hat-trick of aces, just marking his run-up. Resets himself, pre-serve routine. Can he deliver another point? Not from the serving line. So it comes from the block instead as Schweiner gets his hands across the net. That's his third block point. And that's 3 points in a row for the Czech Republic from service. It's a huge lead now. And that time he did, he dropped his right hand into that cross. Really good block from Schweiner. He's done it again. This time he's held the line. And the Czech Republic are surely going to win this one. Schweiner makes a move out and just jumps into the line to deny Irma Kora. 10-point lead for the Czech Republic. But it's a foot fault against Perusic. Against Perusic. Perusic having a word with the referee, not happy about it. But his foot's gone under the line, then he brings it up. When he serves, it's going to be a foot fault. Or if he stands on it, it's a foot fault. Very good serving run it was for Perusic. Schweiner looking for instant side out. Second time of asking. Perusic gets it. 10-point lead. This is not the kind of performance that Austria thought that they were going to be putting in here for a bronze medal. A run of points from the Czech Republic in this second set really has pretty much put them out of sight as we look at that point once again. Schweiner, little jump floaty, comes into block. Oh, brilliant! Absolutely brilliant blocking from David Schweiner. Was he being called for a net touch? Did he touch the net? Makes the touch. Oh, he may well have done on the way down, actually. Well, that was a lucky let-off for the Austria. And an ace serve, courtesy of the net. Schweiner scrambling after that one. They're horrible when the ball does that and hits the net. The sorry, not sorry, the hand goes up to, as a token gesture, really. But right now, Austria will take everything they can get. Either that or he's got a new neck exercise. Stiles with the serve. That's a good ball in from Schweiner. Gives him an opportunity to have a swing, but well read by Pristals. but a little tight to the net. Irma Cora doing well, and eventually Austria managed to get themselves a break point. Worked hard for it. Good covering that from Irma Cora. Good reactions from Pristowers to put the ball down. Bit of a scramble from Schweiner. And that is a wicked shot from Perusic. They look to be out of system for a moment off of the pass, but some speedy legs from Schweiner. Pops it back up and in system, Czech Republic with a big swing and a big point. It is now match point for the Czech Republic. Irma Cora to keep Austria in it. And there's going to be a swing chance. Is there? Yes, there is. Perusic, he's done it. Brilliant, brilliant play from the Czech Republic. And they have taken bronze here in Cancun. Look what it means to them. Fabulous victory for Schweiner and Perusic. Straight sets as well. Irma Cora and his playing partner, Moritz Pristowers, had no answer on the day. All smiles for the Czech Republic. And it's the taste of bitter defeat for Austria into the final four and then lose two on the bounce. The celebrations can start for the Czech Republic and the coaching staff. It was a really good game of beach volleyball by the Czech Republic. Their game plan was solid. They went after Irma Cora. They were aware that he had a few inconsistencies, struggled a little bit on that ball to his right from serving. And Schweiner was able to make a few blocks as well. And then that serving run, really, midway through the second set was the difference from Perusic. Two aces in a row, then two blocks in a row from Schweiner. And after that, there was no looking back. Very consummate performance from the Czech Republic. A couple unforced errors, perhaps too many for Austria, which made the score a little bit more comfortable than perhaps it should have been. But there's no taking away the performance from the Czech Republic. They played really, really well. Very solid. Made some great touches. Played some great transition volleyball. And can look forward to being on the podium later on, taking the bronze medal here in Cancun, the first bronze medal, the first medal to be won of this first event. And there are two more events to come here in Cancun, following on from each other. There's also one more bronze medal match to come. And that will be coming very shortly indeed as Germany take on Brazil. Chantal Labra and Sinja Tillmann of Germany taking on Agata Bednarczuk and Eduarda Duda Lisboa of Brazil. But it's the Czech Republic who've got the job done here on centre court. They take bronze. We hope you enjoyed the volleyball. Let's hear from
Anders, them. Great tournament for you guys. You started losing to this Austrian team 4 days ago. How does it feel to end it winning and taking the bronze medal home?
I mean, the first match was really the worst one out of all. We did so many mistakes. We are not pushing on the serve, and now finally we performed well and it paid off. We had less mistakes in the game, and I think this was the deciding point. We are extremely happy.
And you're coming from the gold medal you won Doha last month. Now another good finish with a third place. How does that help your Olympic run to Tokyo?
It helps really a lot. We already knew before the start of the season that we need to perform really good to qualify for the Olympics. I would say we are one of the teams that benefited a lot from the last year's season or the pandemic, because we had a lot of time to practice our game system and to work on the things that we are not really good at. And I hope that after this result, the Olympics are really, really close.
Congratulations. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Congratulations indeed, from gold to bronze, podium to podium. Brilliant effort from the Czech Republic. We hope you enjoyed the volleyball from all of us here. It is now time to say goodbye.
warm up.